We're riding aboard a rare and ultra-luxurious piece of history. Experiencing what it would have been like to be a passenger on the most famous train in the world. The 20th Century Limited. New York Central's 20th Century Limited was how the rich and famous traveled between New York and Chicago. Known for its opulence and speed, it completed the trip in only 16 hours. Although the days of the century are long gone, an original piece of the last iteration of this train is still riding the rails today. And it's called the Hickory Creek. The Century embodied the spirit of the era, and it was a very highly sought after experience. One which you can still have today, thanks to a dedicated group of volunteers and rail enthusiasts. The United Railroad Historical Society of New Jersey owns the Hickory Creek and continually offers rides on the historic car. Staff and volunteers go to great lengths to create an authentic experience as close as possible to what it would have been like as a passenger on the Century. This train had luxuries and amenities experienced by almost no other rail passengers at the time. The famous train has long been credited with creating the concept of the red carpet treatment, now a mainstay of Hollywood premieres. Fitting since Hollywood's most famous entertainers were among the Century's passengers. The train had other unheard-of conveniences for rail travelers, such as an onboard barbershop. And on our trip up the Hudson, we noticed one other feature in the car that seemed a bit out of place for a train from the early 1900s. A telephone. Surely this had to be a modern addition. Nope, believe it or not, the Century had a phone that was connected to a landline when the train was in the station. For an additional fee, one could make a last-minute phone call before the train departed. This was an all-sleeping car train, serving only the most affluent in society. Rooms were well-appointed with fresh linens and had an attendant to cater to your every need. When the Hickory Creek was restored, 4 bedrooms were installed instead of the original 5 in order to make room for a larger kitchen, one that could prepare full meals instead of just the bar snacks that would have been prepared on this car in the 40s. The bedrooms also did not originally have showers, but were added when the car was restored to better suit the needs of passengers on private railcar excursions. When the Century was re-equipped after World War II, these Creek series of observation cars were surely the stars of the new consists. And the highlight of these cars was the lookout lounge. Raised up 2 steps higher and fitted with some of the largest windows ever to be installed on a rail car, this lounge still provides sweeping views of the Hudson River Valley as the Hickory Creek travels along New York Central's famous water level route. Up next, watch our video from season 1 about the Hickory Creek and see plenty of exterior shots of the car running along the Hudson River. And if you like what we're doing here, please like and subscribe to help us bring you more videos just like this one. We'll see you next week.